The giver. Emperor Akbar was a very intelligent king. He always encouraged his courtiers to talk and discuss topics of wisdom. One day, Emperor Akbar was sitting in his court. He and his courtiers were discussing various topics like generosity and kindness. Akbar wanted to know what his courtiers thought, and said, "The hand of the giver is always above the hand of the receiver." Everyone seemed to give it a thought. They all agreed with him. Birbal was still in thought. Akbar asked him, "What are you thinking?" Birbal replied, "Your Majesty, the hand of the giver is not above that of the receiver in all cases." Akbar was irritated. He thought to himself, "Birbal always thinks he knows everything." Then he said to Birbal, "Then, when is the hand of the receiver above that of the giver?" In response, Birbal went away and came back with a handful of nuts. He offered them to Akbar and said, "The hand of the receiver is above when someone offers him nuts. In such a case, the hand of the giver is below." Akbar praised Birbal's presence of mind. The value of the sword. One day, Birbal heard his neighbor, an old lady, crying. He asked her the reason. "My son died in battle, and now there is no one to look after me," she said. Birbal felt sorry for her. Then he asked, "Do you have anything to give the emperor?" The old lady had only her son's sword. Birbal said, "Give it to the emperor. He will surely give you something in return." The old lady went to the royal court and said, "Your Majesty, my son was in your army and is now dead. I brought his sword to you so that it can be used again." The emperor looked at it and said, "The sword is rusted and cannot be used." He ordered the servant to give a few coins to the old lady. Birbal saw this and said, "Your Majesty, let me have a look at the sword. I have heard things turn into gold with the emperor's touch. Wonder why this has not turned into gold." The emperor immediately instructed his servants to weigh the sword. Then he gave the old lady gold coins equal to the weight of the sword. The old lady went home happy, crying at the river. Emperor Akbar enjoyed going for long evening walks. Sometimes he went alone, but many times Birbal joined him too. Mostly, he liked to walk along the banks of the beautiful Yamuna River. He loved the sound of the river flowing by. One such evening, Akbar was taking a walk along with Birbal by the riverside. While listening to the sound of the river, he felt as if the river were crying. So he asked, "Birbal, can you tell me why is the river crying now?" Birbal was taken aback. He thought, "Oh, what a strange question. I must give a sensible answer." He stared at the river and thought for a while. "Your Majesty, the mountain is the river's father. The sea is the river's husband. The river flows down from the mountain to the sea. She leaves her father behind to meet her husband. But she loves her father and misses him. She is sad upon leaving him. Thus, she is always crying." "What a beautiful reason, Birbal," said Akbar. "Here, take this pearl necklace as a reward." Birbal was happy with the reward. However, what made him happier was that he had pleased Emperor Akbar. How was the ghost? Emperor Akbar was always testing Birbal. Once, he got his carpenters to make a special cupboard. If anyone touched this cupboard, he would get stuck to it. The next day, he called Birbal and said, "There is an apple in that cupboard. Please get it for me." When Birbal touched the cupboard to open it, he got stuck. He tried his best, but could not get free. He did not shout, as he felt silly. Soon, Akbar came there and said, "Caught you." Then onwards, Akbar often teased him by saying, "How was the ghost of the apple?" Birbal thought of a plan to stop him. One day, when Akbar went hunting, he hid in the forest. Luckily for Birbal, Akbar got separated from his soldiers. As he was about to rest under a tree, a scary ghost attacked him. Akbar fainted. The soldiers found him and took him back. Akbar did not tell anyone anything. Some days later, in court, Akbar teased Birbal, "How was the ghost of the apple?" So Birbal said, "How was the ghost of the forest?" Akbar was shocked. He then realized that Birbal had dressed up as the ghost. He never teased Birbal again. The lesson in hospitality. One day, Birbal decided to travel to another city. Some of his relatives lived there. So Birbal went to Emperor Akbar and asked, "Your Majesty, I want to visit my relatives in another city. May I go?
Sure,
said Akbar. So, Birbal set off in his carriage driven by horses. He took food and water along with him for the journey. Now, Birbal's relatives did not want any guests to come to their house. When they saw Birbal's carriage, they were annoyed. They quickly thought of a plan to get rid of him. They went to the balcony and pretended to have a huge fight. The husband even picked up a stick and acted like he was beating his wife. However, Birbal was not fooled. He understood that his relatives were pretending to make him go back. I will teach them a lesson, he thought. He went and hid in the nearby bushes. Soon the couple stopped fighting. We were good. Birbal has gone. I have not gone, said Birbal, jumping out of the bushes. L was also pretending, just like
you.
Couple were ashamed. They said sorry and promised to be nice to their guests in the future.